हेलो चिल्ड्रन, नमस्कार। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डू चैप्टर नंबर 2, नेमिंग वर्ड्स। एंड द लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ दिस लेसन इज एट द एंड ऑफ दिस लेसन यू विल बी एबल टू लर्न एंड यूज द टर्म नाउन टू रेफर टू नेमिंग वर्ड्स। यू कैन ऑल्सो बी एबल टू क्लासीफाई अ नाउन एज द नेम ऑफ पर्सन, प्लेस, एनिमल और थिंग। आपको आइडेंटिफाई करना आ जाएगा नाउन कोई भी सेंटेंस में से भी। दैट मीन्स यू विल एबल टू आइडेंटिफाई नाउन इन अ गिवन सेंटेंस। सम मोर लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव्स आर यू कैन ऑल्सो बी एबल टू आइडेंटिफाई कॉमन नाउन, आइडेंटिफाई प्रॉपर नाउन। यू कैन ऑल्सो बी एबल टू आइडेंटिफाई द डिफरेंस बिटवीन प्रॉपर नाउन एंड कॉमन नाउन। इवन यू कैन स्पेयर आउट, फिगर आउट व्हाट काइंड ऑफ नाउन इट इज। आपको ये भी पता चल जाएगा कि ये कौन से काइंड का नाउन है। ऑलराइट, सो लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड। फर्स्टली वी विल सी व्हाट इज नाउन। एज वी ऑल नो दैट नाउन आर द नेम ऑफ पर्सन, प्लेस, एनिमल और थिंग। हियर आर फ्यू एग्जांपल्स ऑफ नाउन, दैट इज मदर, फादर, काउ, पिग, table, book, school. Here mother and father are what? Name of person. Cow and pig are name of animal. Table, book is name of thing. And school is name of place. So we can say noun is the name of person, place, animal or thing. Now let's see the types of noun. There are two categories of noun given here. They are common and proper noun. Now, what is a common noun? Common noun are general name of person, place, animal, thing. They do not have any specific name. So, we can say they do not use to specify items. But proper nouns are what? Proper nouns refers to unique entity. That means they have their specific name, particular name. All right. Such as New York, Saturn, George, Washington. This all are what? Proper names. Now let's see some examples of common name and proper name. Common noun, proper noun. Car, Ferrari. Car is common noun, whereas Ferrari is the name of that car. That means particularly we had given the name. So it's a proper name. Now movie, Deadpool. Tea, Earl Grey. Drink, Coca-Cola. Website, EnglishStudyHere.com. Man, Usain Bolt. School, Cambridge University. Now, biscuit, Oreo. Mountain, Mount Everest. State, here we had not specified the name of the state, so it's a common name. But state, California, it's a proper noun. We had particularly given the name. Then cat, Tom, mouse, Jerry, ocean, Indian Ocean, building, Empire State. So these are some examples of common noun and proper noun. Now turn the page and come to page number 16. Here they had given noun, proper and common. They have a name, they do not have a name. Examples, Audi, England, Justin, Pepsi, English 10. Example, car, country, singer, drink and app. Now, come to the exercise portion. Circle common noun and underline the spatial nouns. Spatial means proper nouns. So let's get started with the exercise portion. Take out your pencil and eraser. So here is the first exercise. Circle common noun and underline spatial, that is proper noun. The first question of the first exercise is, Mr. Verma is a doctor in this hospital. Underline Mr. Verma as it is a proper noun. Circle doctor and hospital as it is a common noun because they are not specified and it's a general name. So we will underline Mr. Verma and circle doctor and hospital. Now come to the second question. We always travel by Air India. Air India is proper name. So underline Air India. Then come to third one. Vidhi wants to be an actress when she grow up. Circle actress and underline Vidhi. As Vidhi is what? Proper noun. An actress is common noun. Now come to fourth one. October is the month after September. Underline October, circle month and underline September. Now turn the page and come to page number 17. The fifth one is, the Red Fort is a monument. Circle monument and write it down. Sorry, you need not have to write circle monument. Now underline Red Fort as it is a proper noun. Now see the sixth one. We will go to Delhi, underline Delhi, by the Rajdhani Express. Underline Rajdhani Express as it is what? Proper name. Now come to seventh one. Sachin Tendulkar is a cricketer. Sachin Tendulkar is cricketer. Underline Sachin Tendulkar as it is a proper name, name of person specifically and particularly given. Then circle cricketer as it is a common name. Now come to eighth one. Jyoti gave the book Oliver Twist to her classmate. Underline Jyoti, circle book, underline Oliver Twist and circle classmate. Book and classmate are common names, where Oliver Twist and Jyoti is proper name. Now come to the ninth one. Rajvi and Somnath are friends. Rajvi is again a proper name. Somnath is again a proper name, as they are special name of persons. Then friend is common name. Now come to the last one. Arun will visit Kolkata in October. Underline Arun, underline Kolkata, underline October. In this sentence, all the nouns are proper nouns. Now we are going to learn about countable noun and uncountable nouns. What do you mean by countable noun, dear kids? Jisko hum count kar sakte hain. And what do you mean by uncountable nouns? Jisko hum nahi count kar sakte. Ye to hua simple definition, jo ki hum Hindi mein bol sakte hain. Now let us see in English. Countable noun can be counted, uncountable noun cannot be counted. Now see, can take singular and plural verb. Countable noun में singular और plural दोनों हो सकता है. Whereas in uncountable noun there is always a singular verb. Here singular and plural verb both, and here only singular verb. Now let's see the examples. An apple, a school, one picture, two pictures, etc. Here sugar, information, water, understanding, etc. We cannot count water. हम water को count कर सकते हैं क्या? नहीं. Sugar को count कर सकते हैं क्या? नहीं. Now there is a book on the table. There is a book, मतलब वहाँ पे एक book है on the table. Whereas those houses are very big. Houses means plural form use किया हमने. Those houses are very big, aren't they? Now let's see. Uncountable noun always takes singular verbs. For example, there is some water in that picture. Alright. वहाँ पे some water means थोड़ा पानी है. But it's a singular verb. Okay, now turn the page, come to page number 18. In page number 18, there is a list of countable and uncountable noun which you have to read. Tick and write it down, read. Let us see. Bun is countable. Sandwich is countable. Apple is countable. Orange is countable. Burger countable. Fries countable. Eggs countable. Salad countable. Vegetable countable. Cookies countable. Potatoes countable. Tomato countable. Carrot countable. Hot dog countable. Candies countable. Olives countable. Peanuts countable. Pancake countable. Watermelon countable. Pea countable. Grapes countable. Cherries countable. Now, what are the things which are uncountable? Let's see. Bread, uncountable. Fruits, uncountable. Juice, uncountable. Meat, uncountable. Rice, uncountable. Cereal, uncountable. Jam, uncountable. Milk, uncountable. Coffee, uncountable. Sugar, uncountable. Flour, uncountable. Juice, uncountable. Salad, uncountable. Sorry, salt, uncountable. Soup, uncountable. Tea, uncountable. Cottage cheese, uncountable. Pasta, uncountable. Honey, uncountable. Water, uncountable. Cheese, uncountable. Butter is also uncountable. Seafood is also uncountable. Mustard is also uncountable. Now turn the page and come to the exercise portion. Now let's see the exercise of page number 19. We have to write countable for C and uncountable for U. We will write UC for uncountable. So add U and C. Okay. So let's see here. Bread, uncountable. Water, uncountable. Apple, countable. Rice, uncountable. Potato, countable. Banana, countable. Right sugar, UC. Salt, UC. Burger, C. Biscuit, C. Carrot, C. Onion, countable. Grapes, countable. Butter, uncountable. Orange, countable. Milk, we cannot count milk, so it's uncountable. Juice, uncountable. Coffee, also uncountable. Cherry, countable. Meat, uncountable. Now let's see. There is, there are. For more than one we write are. For only one we write is. So first one is, there is an apple. Second one is, there is some sugar. Third one is, there are some carrots. Fourth one is, there is a banana. Fifth one is, there is some rice. There is butter. There is some chicken. There are cakes. There are two oranges. There are some cherries. There is some juice. There are some grapes. There is milk. And there is some bread. Now dear kids, turn the page and come to page number 20. I hope that you all understand this exercise, as we have to differentiate between countable and uncountable items. Then we have to write there is and there are. For the things belongs to countable, and for the things that do not belongs to countable, that means that belongs to uncountable nouns. Now turn the page, come to page number 20. Page number 20, countable noun versus uncountable noun. This question, this exercise is your homework for the date 22/6/20. What you have to do is, the things which belongs to countable, you need to write countable. The things which do not belongs to countable nouns, you need to write uncountable UC, or you can write U. Alright, so this question is your homework, and keep studying. Bye, take care, and thank you.